Hi lovelies, I'm so glad you could be with me today. We are doing the case analysis of Summer Wells. As a lot of you might have seen, I've already put up a tarot reading that I did last night regarding Summer and, you know, who might be involved in her disappearance, where she might be, etc. And looking into the energy of her father, her mother, Candace and Donald Wells as well. And I think I also looked into, well, some other stuff came up around maybe Candace having a separate lover or someone she's interested in romantically aside from Donald. And there was some speculation going around Hunter, but I'm not sure what the validity of that is. For all we know, it could just be rumours, guys. And, you know, Chinese whispers can be quite dangerous in some ways. People can start to become like, it's, you know, jump onto things and just, it turns into this mass hysteria, you know, it's really crazy. So I just want to really try and work with facts as much as I can, and what has come through the tarot reading, as well as the spirit sessions, because I was quite surprised, you know, looking at what came through with the spirit session and the tarot reading, because as I explained to a lot of you in the spirit session that I did in the tarot reading, I didn't want to be influenced by any new recent news articles or anything on Facebook or, you know, social media. I had people messaging me saying, check out this video and that. I just said, no, I won't check them out until after my reading because I want to see what happens then, because I don't like being influenced. But on saying that, when I actually had, you know, looked into certain interviews with the family, and I've checked up on certain things on Facebook, also on Google, you know, just checking up and confirming things myself, going onto Google Maps, and it's pretty interesting what's come up, guys. And I mean, you may or may not believe in this stuff, you know, tarot reading, spirit sessions, that's completely fine, everybody has their thing. Just, you know, keep it classy, guys, don't need to be nasty or rude at all, you'll be blocked. I had someone attacking me because I used the F word in my last tarot reading. Oh my god. I'm sorry, guys, but you know, I'm not someone who swears all the time, if ever, in my readings. I got passionate about the things that were coming up and I just couldn't help it. I was swearing. Yeah, I did swear. But, yeah. Oh god. But put that aside, you know, this is serious. So, yes, I do get passionate sometimes, but what I'm saying is you're allowed to disagree, you're allowed to be skeptical. I mean, I'm skeptical of the apps that I use, even though, you know, I've been using some apps. The new ones, I just used new apps just recently that I was really skeptical about, but once I started putting two and two together and thinking, holy crap, this guy on this spirit app keeps saying Bradshaw, and when I look on the map, there is a Bradshaw Street in Rogersville. There's also a town called Bradshaw in Tennessee. So I'm like, well, what the hell's this? You know, it was just really amazing to me. And some other clues have come through that I'd like to connect with things as well. Maybe you guys listening might have some ideas as well, if you've seen or heard things, or even if you're in the area, you know, of Rogersville. You might very much know what's going on here, you know, with certain things that come up. So I'm all for the skeptics and I'm all for the believers, whatever. I just want you to be nice, okay? Be kind, guys. All right, so what's happening is I'm going to have a look. I went back through the spirit session clues, okay? So you can see a slide here with all these different words and some of them form a sentence. This is how spirits speak. I would have loved to have shown you the actual spirit session, but I just don't have time, and it didn't come through the speakers very clearly, which was really annoying because I really wanted to share it with you. But some people are so skeptical because, and I understand it, believe me, I do, because I'm absolutely gobsmacked and in awe of how spirit contact me, you know, how they connect with me. I've not seen it with anyone else. I've not seen any other videos with spirit boxes or anything like that, where spirit communicate in this way that I talk to them. People expect it to be all this static noise and whispers coming through EVPs. I mean, that does happen. Yes, it does. But for some reason, Spirit actually talked to me through using the apps. They take the words out of the internet channels that are scanning through, and they will form a sentence. Okay, but it's not how we talk. It's not like making sense, okay, in order. So that's why I said here it's not in order. Some are not in order. Some info may even be irrelevant. You know, one says here, I'm Jeff. That's another spirit coming through. Okay, I don't believe that's anything to do with this case. So that's the whole point of this. It takes so much time and energy as well to try and decode what is with this, you know, information is with this case and what's something else. You know, sometimes spirit come through and want to talk about their own case, you know, so it's a matter of just trying to separate the information. Sometimes it's totally irrelevant. Sometimes it can just be the internet adverts coming through, so you just have to really separate it. But what I find really amazing is that certain things have come through, even things that I wasn't even aware of that were valid, you know, relevant to this case until I confirmed it through Google. And through the interview that I watched of a retired detective, thanks Wade for putting me onto his channel. Absolutely amazing. He's just really awesome. He's called Chris from the Interview Room, which I have to explain in a minute more about that. But yeah, he did an interview on the Boy Hunter, and he's, I think about to do an interview with Candace. And he's also, yeah, he's just amazing what he's done. He's gone out there to Rogersville. He's shown around the places that they went to, you know, to that day. So yeah, I'm sorry if I sound really puffed out. I'm just so tired today, guys. You know, a lot of you know I've got chronic fatigue. I'm just so damn tired, but I want to get this done today. So basically, what we got here, okay, is an example of how spirits speak. There'll be so many internet scans going through the channels. I'll get a word, right? I'll get a word like pizza, and then I'll get like, I'm hungry, and then it'll come through all these other words and things, and then it'll say, tried to eat. So to me, it's like, I'm hungry, I tried to eat something. So she's hungry. She said, I'm hungry. This is how I'm interpreting it. That Summer said, I'm hungry. And, you know, she might have tried to eat. Okay, she might have tried to have dinner, because it says dinner. There's pizza written here as well. Maybe they tried to have pizza. But I found it quite interesting when I did watch the interview room with the detective Chris, how he'd mentioned in one of his interviews, in one of his videos that I was watching, he said something about that they were eating pizza. And I'm like, okay, that's an interesting connection. Maybe that's coming through for that. I don't really know, but I just, yeah, my eyes raised with that. So anyway, let's get started. So we got Bradshaw at the top. So there is a Bradshaw Street in Tennessee, and it is 32 minutes away from Ben Hill Road, where Summer and her family live. And it's between 18 to 25 minutes drive to Hawkins County Airport, which was another clue that's come through about an airport and planes. So Hawkins County Airport to Ben Hill Road is a 32 minute drive. And so when I can put them on the map together, it looks like a triangle going from Ben Hill Road to the airport to Bradshaw Street. So I'm not the best person with mapping and things like that. I'm hopeless when it comes to mathematics. But what I see here is this is Ben Hill Road right here, okay, where Summer and her family live. We've got the airport over here, which is the clue Spirit gave. And down here, if you look back on the other one, the other slide that I have, this is where Bradshaw Street is right here. So I haven't been able to do anything through paint or whatever, but you can imagine a line going straight across here to Ben Hill Road, then to the airport, like to the airport, okay, and then down to Bradshaw. So it's like a triangle. And to me, that shows me that these are main significant points Spirit is showing us, okay? This is just how I read it. So she could be at any of these areas around here, or she could be within this triangle that spirit are giving us. So as you can see, the next clue on there is horse, which was amazing because in my tarot session, tarot reading, so many of the cards came up that had horses in them. And I thought, this is significant for some reason. And then when I watched the interview with Chris McDonough, I think his name is, the retired detective who was interviewing Hunter, and his part two video where he went out to Rogersville and he was looking around at all the places that Candace and Hunter had said that they were at. I didn't know, but there was a place called Warrior. Oh, geez, now I'm trying to remember the name of it. I'll post a thing on here, but where they went swimming that day at the swimming hole is actually called a horse pond. And amazing, because in the video you see this detective is driving up into that area, and right there is this big horse stables and ranch, and you can see all these horses. And I was like, oh my God, like that is so in line with what is being said here. So but I thought initially when I got the spirit session, which could still be right, I'm not sure, that's where they're saying she is. Like they're saying that she's near a horse. You know, maybe her body is out in a paddock or near stables or something. That's how I read it. But it's just interesting that things are coming up and popping up. And then as you'll see, just now this weekend, there's an equisearch. I think they call it equisearch. Equisearch, equestrian search or something. From Texas, okay, they're coming in. They're a mounted search and recovery team. They provide volunteer horses for recovery for lost and missing persons. It's just amazing. And they're coming in to help find Summer. They're extremely professional. They're a volunteer organization. And they have people from students, electricians, housewives, former FBI and law enforcement and current law enforcement, US Marshals, Coast Guards and all walks of military, former and current, okay, on their team. And they can do everything from horse and rider teams to foot searches and ATVs. They conduct water searches using boats, divers and sonar equipment. And they also perform air searches using planes, guys. What did spirit say? Planes? With the plane? Oh my God, they said with the plane. That makes sense. Maybe when we're looking at the spirit session on the slide there where it says with a plane. I'm pretty sure it says with a plane. If I'll have to go back and look at it. But that could mean that she's found. You know, maybe she's found with the use of a plane. So they use small drones and things like that as well. With highly sophisticated cameras. So, and they have infrared and night vision cameras along with ground penetration units in some of their searches. So it's just absolutely amazing what these guys do. And I'm praying to God that they're going to find her using this stuff, because apparently they can detect if ground has been unearthed. So I took this picture off Google. This is the Warriors Path State Park where they went that day at Kingsport. This is where the horses are. And this is what's called the horse pond. This is like the water hole, you know, the swimming hole that Candace took Summer and Hunter to that day and her mother. So I'm not sure what he's 17 is. Some things might come to light later on, or it could just be irrelevant information. Because I know Hunter is 15. He's a minor. I'm not sure if anyone is 17 that they know. Could be something relevant. May not be. He'll plead sick. Made me think, okay, is someone going to plead insanity or something? You know, if there is someone that's caught. He'll plead sick, so that's pretty interesting. And then we've got the number 45. That could be an age, that could be someone's house number, could be a business number, just could be a sign that someone sees 45, could be a number of a highway. Just got to keep our minds open what 45 might mean. Then it says plane near an airport. And then we've got the creek, which is pretty interesting because, I mean, they do come from the Beach Creek community. And we've also got a creek that you can definitely see. It's all curving around, right, and goes through where the airport is there. So the name Matthews has come up quite a few times in the spirit sessions that I did, and I did them over, I think, three different apps at different days and different times, and the name Matthew kept coming through, and at one point it said Matthew, and then it kept saying Matthews. So I'm thinking, is that a surname of somebody, Matthews? I know that when I did some searching, Candace does have someone with the surname Matthews on her profile, like her old, I know it must be her new profile, I think. I don't know if those people are involved in any way, so don't go jumping on it. People, just stay calm. But you know, there is that, I've noticed that. So that's just some connection, it may mean nothing. But yeah, I did check into that. But there's also, I did some searching again on Google, Matthews in Rogersville, and there is a guy called Vincent Matthews, and there's another one called Robert Matthews. I don't know if they're related, but they've both been charged for drug-related offences. And it just got me thinking with this whole Candace and the drug dealer type thing, could these guys be connected in some way with her? I have no idea. I haven't seen anything on her Facebook or anything like that that connects her. But I just once again had to follow the spirit session clue, and this is what's come up. So I don't know, guys, they could be in connection with her, or it may not be anything to do with her. So we've got the words restaurant, pizza, I'm hungry, tried to eat, have dinner with them next to it. You know, there's just things, maybe they did go off to have some pizza or something. And I think if I remember, it's just coming to me now, actually. I did see a interview that from the interview room today with Allyson, is her name? Hunter's mother? I'm pretty sure it's Allyson. She was saying something that the Candace would only give her children like dollar pizzas or something. I'm pretty sure. I'd have to go back and listen. But that's just reminded me right now, thinking, did she try to eat a pizza or something? I don't know. It's all very strange, but someone will know. Apparently, Summer didn't really eat on the day. She was just given candy. I'm not sure if she had anything to eat, but it's interesting they're saying, I'm hungry and tried to eat. So yes, and now we've also got friend of Bali, could have been Bailey, didn't hear it too clearly. And it says their auntie found Chris. Now I found that really interesting because at the time, you know, a day later after doing this, spirit session, or 2 days later, I found the interview room and his name is Chris. The guy that's interviewing everyone. So I'm thinking, isn't it interesting that Summer's auntie actually is missing? Rosie Marie, I think her name is. Once again, I have to look more into that one. But her auntie is missing since 2009. And it's her auntie. So it's saying their auntie found Chris. I'm wondering, has she led, you know, Chris to this case? Has she helped to, you know, help to kind of guide this along the way for Chris to come in and be involved in this? I really do believe in that stuff. Does native mean flowers? You know, is it a pink flower? Because we're seeing native and pink, and then it says her flower, things like that. So was it a pink flower? And I did see on Candace's TikTok video today a pink flower that she's taken a video of at the waterhole. So that's quite interesting. And it's just one on its own too. Native could also be someone local to the area. Now we've got the slab of rock. Is she buried under a slab of rock? Have they put a slab of rock over her her grave? It says a van came. So, you know, there is this speculation that she was trafficked, you know, maybe there was a drug debt that Candace needed to pay and she's given her daughter away to pay for that debt. That's just speculation. There's no proof, as far as I know, anywhere that that's the case. But it's interesting, it's saying a van came and friends, so did friends turn up somewhere? And it kept saying the snake, like a couple of times in the app, spirit app, it kept saying the snake. And then in my tarot reading, all these cards were coming up with snakes on them. And I'm thinking, is this a literal snake? Or are they talking about like an enemy, a person, as like being a snake amongst friends? You know, it's just after the friends. So I'm wondering, is there a snake amongst them somewhere? Things like need a coffee could have been something that someone had said. Sometimes spirit will come through with the exact phrases that someone has used. I'm not really sure what the passage means. It could be an underground passage somewhere. And then we see I'm Jeff, which is another spirit coming through. But they've said buried her, and I have always thought they buried her. And the carer watches, that's an interesting thing. So who is the carer? The carer is supposed to be perhaps the grandmother or the mother, you know, as the carer. But I'm not really sure what that means as yet. Medical supply they needed, very interesting. Because as we found out through the interviews that Candace's mother had a knee injury and had to go and get painkillers or some medication for her knee. But I also wonder if Spirit is saying, you know, they needed to get medical supplies for Summer. We just don't know, because they're saying straight after that, hit her head. You know, she's hit her head. She's either hit her head on something or someone has hit her on the head. And then Spirit said the lost person was towards around a building site. And that was a full sentence that he'd said, like the voice of the Spirit, you know, saying that. So I thought, okay, where's there a building site? Is this a work site? Is she around there somewhere? And then they say they are almost secret. I don't really know what that means. They are almost secret. Someone is almost a secret. Is something a secret that's, you know, almost a secret? But people know about something? I'm not sure. He was this way. I don't know what that means. Summer knows who is, so she obviously knows who has done this to her. We've got circles in a hole. I've got no idea what that means. Can you please help me with that? I don't know what that means. Circles in a hole. Is it water circles? I don't know. Like circles in a water. No idea. And number the watch. When I heard number the watch, I thought instantly a crime scene where law enforcement will put down certain numbers on the ground or wherever. And so I thought, that's very interesting. It sounds like a crime scene, number the watch. So does the person whoever's done this to her or taken her somewhere and buried her, is there a watch there? Is there something around a watch, you know? And one spirit said, I think she's cargo. So maybe they're speculating themselves, which they can actually do. Not all of them know what's going on. They might have come through and thought, okay, she's in a car, she's gone. And they'll sign it. So who's going to sign some documents? That'll be very interesting. What will they sign? On the beach. So they said beach a few times. And I'm thinking, are they meaning a real beach with waves? Or are they talking about like a swimming hole kind of beach? Lake type thing? I don't know. They said door. So the door is... maybe there's been some speculation about the basement door or the back door to the house. So there's something maybe there. Hasn't really said much about that. And then we've got an apartment written there. Have dinner with them next to it. Deck her eyes. I've got no idea what that means. Deck her eyes. No idea. You know, sometimes that's a slang for deck her. Like, let's punch her or hit her. Who knows? Quit time. Ghost. Claire. Pool. Obviously is a swimming pool. The swimming hole. The store. So they've gone to a shop and her death. Maybe she was dead then, you know, maybe she had passed away at the store. I don't know. It doesn't have to all be in order, but, you know, I'm just speculating as we go along as well. And there's a picture of her circulating around that people think, okay, she's dead in the picture. A lot of people are saying, no, she's not, because she's not blue and she's not, you know, it just, well, it's hard to know, isn't it? Because it's a picture. And one person saying she was alive when they saw her. In the car, and others are saying, well, we don't really know, you know, so there is a real concern with that. And we've got beer, so I don't know if they're actually drinking beer. I don't know what twisted tea is, but it's an alcoholic drink. So for all I know, it could be some kind of fruit alcoholic drink, or I'll have to look it up actually. But it's interesting, it's saying beer, it's making reference to alcohol. And it's saying a white bin. So is she in a white bin? Is there some evidence in a white bin? Yes, it's interesting. And it says her mother fined or her mother fine. Yeah, mother seems fine with everything, sort of. So we've got the word choke. Did Summer choke on something? Was she choked? You know, and then it says college engineer top. I have no idea what that means. Is this someone who's gone to uni? You know, they're a graduate. Now they're an engineer. They're right at the top. Paint. Someone might paint. So this whoever's involved are just giving clues. If there is someone that did take Summer on behalf of the Wells, okay, the parents. This could be clues about that person. Now, it said by the hippo bin. I've never heard of a hippo bin. But when I googled it, it's an actual skip bin. And apparently they're in Australia, so I don't have any idea if they're in Tennessee or if people call them that. I'd only heard about it just when I heard the spirit session. And I'm thinking, what the hell is a hippo bin? Which is so odd because the voices that are used in the app are American. So I was thinking, well, it has to be known in America. But upon Googling, I couldn't find anything. So let me know, guys, if you have heard the term hippo bin, which is an actual skip bin. So has she been placed in there? Has evidence been placed in there? You know, because I also looked up a waste recycling place as well, because I thought that might be relevant in some ways to this case. And that, I think, was 39 minutes away from their home. But then it says he plays clarinet, he wears this cross, which is interesting because there's a few references about the Lord and, yeah, my God and things like that, which is really interesting because they are Christians, especially the father, Donald Wells, is constantly preaching things. So that's interesting. That's really interesting. And they're not real silver hats, or the cross or jewelry may not be real silver. I'm not sure what that's in reference to. We've got dogs. Well, they had heaps of dogs. I don't know how many, but there's a lot on their property. And I don't know where the bridge is, guys. So that's something I'll have to look into. The bridge. So, I mean, there could be bridges everywhere. But, you know, it could be a significant bridge that we could be looking at. In maybe in that triangle that I showed you. And it says lie detector. Interesting. It's so interesting because of all the things to talk about, they actually did go have a lie detector test, okay? So it's interesting, it says, tell a story, be my boy. And that was in order. So I'm thinking, you know, because over here, if you look to the right, it says down the bottom, come up with a plan. So I'm thinking, someone's told somebody, there's a plan being made on what to say. They're telling a story, okay? And it says, be my boy. What the hell is that? Be my boy. Is that Candace with Hunter saying, be my boy, be a good boy, tell this story? You know, it's very strange, guys. And there has been speculation once again that Candace and Hunter have had some kind of an involvement romantically. And don't forget, he's a minor. Okay, there's some very interesting and weird things that have come up around that. I'll show you here. So on May 28th, 2020, he puts that he's in a relationship on May 27th, you know, the day before. And what he's done is he's gone and on the same day, whether it be straight after, I don't know because there's no time on it, he's actually put up a photo of him and Candace together, hugging each other, you know, just putting their arms around one another, which could be a friendly, innocent thing. I just find it really interesting that, you know, he's put his inner relationship and then straight away put them, those, you know, him and her hugging as a cover photo. And what I noticed is that he loved that. He loved his own post. And then I noticed Candace's mother, who's also named Candace, loved the post as well. It's creepy. Anyway, that's what I think's a bit creepy. But then when we see the actual conversation on that post, the one where it says in a relationship, it gets a little bit disturbing. So Candace says, with who? Your hand, you know, meaning are you in a relationship with your hand? And he goes, yep, Rosie a palm and her five sisters or something. And then Candace says, and her brothers. And then he says, fuck you too. And then she says, no, bro, I don't fuck my homies. Really weird, guys. Really weird. And then we've got some angry people on here, you know, getting on his post and saying he's 15, you're a grown woman. You know, when you left this vile comment, he was 14. He's a minor. You know, we don't know the full story of what's happened on that day, but I believe Candace has told him to shut up, basically. And there's more to the story than what we know. But I still believe he's a minor, and I believe a lot of what he's been saying is truth. He does have ADHD, and they can forget timelines, you know, the times of things and when things occurred. Apparently, Candace had said he'd gotten the times wrong with when they went to what store, you know, it wasn't in the right order or something. But that doesn't make him a criminal. We don't really know what his whole role was that day, you know, in relation to Summer going missing. All we know is that he was there. And yeah, he's come forward, he's talked to the TBI, the FBI, to the interview room, this homicide detective. And yes, there might be some things he might be hiding some stuff. We don't know. He is a teenager. But at the end of the day, he is a minor, guys. Candace is the adult. And she and Donald are the adults in this. And they need to come forward and tell the truth. So then, you know, Hunter's responded to Candace on his post saying, wow, I'm not you. And she goes, no, you are Sherry. And he goes, nope. And she goes, okay. And then in this bold, like some kind of meme or whatever it is, she's gone, explain. And then in the next one, she's gone, game over. It's so bizarre. It's almost like saying, explain, okay, you haven't explained yourself, we're over now, type thing. Like a relationship. It's just so damn weird. So the other clues here regarding Summer, it says it's the Lord, too late now, could mean that she's in the arms of the Lord, and it's too late, she's deceased. And I wasn't sure whether it said look who's back or Luke is back. I'm not sure what that one was. The word poor came through, so they aren't very wealthy there. They're not rich, you know, they're coming from a poor background. On Rikers, I don't know what that is. There was a display case business or something, but I don't think it's got anything to do with this. I really don't know what that is. And then I heard Spirit say, ah, I heard she was. And then it said, beer writes much. And then it said American. So that's what I'm talking about with the sentences. That American came in 5 scans later. But I've understood it to be, ah, I heard she was American. They're asking a question. I said, yeah, she's from Tennessee. Beer writes much. Kind of sounds like, you know, we've got all these rights to have beer or something, I don't know. And then it said girlfriend, married now. It's interesting because I think Hunter said he has a girlfriend. So that could just be in reference to that. Or it could mean something else, I'm not sure. Saying girlfriend, married now. Her and Donald are married. Could be something irrelevant. It's 5:10, could be the time, a specific time when Summer was, you know, deceased. That could be a time of death. It could be the height of somebody. 5:10. So then we have dress. So I think she was wearing a dress. She did wear dresses. And going back to that other clue that it said pink, when I said it might have been a native pink flower, she actually was dressed in pink shorts on the day that she was swimming in that at the swimming hole. And it says at school, colours, things like that. I'm wondering if there is a connection with a school somewhere nearby. Once again, maybe in that triangle there that we saw on the map. Because in the tarot session, it came up with books, and there was art, like arts, I think there's paints and different things, which is interesting. It's coming up on this one here, paints and school and colours. So is there an art school nearby or some kind of craft place? I don't know, we've got to think outside the box. And it says, wife, they're nice, he's good. Don't know what that's about. The name Rochelle came through, and then dinner. And then I heard very clearly the spirit say, "Hi, Mark." And so that's a very special message for a viewer of ours, I believe. So anyone named Mark, someone's coming through to say hello to you, I believe. Which is pretty cool. They do that sometimes. So we got... Then, that's right, the spirit said, "Know what flower she..." So that was, part of another sentence that was way before, where the guy on the app said, "Her flower." And I actually asked, "What flower are you talking about? What is it?" And the woman said, "Know what flower she..." So maybe she was saying, "I don't know what flower she was," you know, didn't finish the sentence. So that's just what it says there, "Know what flower she." So there's something about that. It's just so interesting that it came up a few times talking about flowers. And I'm thinking, didn't she say that they were planting flowers? I just found this so amazing, guys. Now, the other thing here, it says, "Eddie, bet it's him." And it was interesting because the guy had said the word "Eddie" and then the woman said, "Bet it's him." So he's saying, "Eddie, bet it's him." Which just freaked me out because knowing how I am with my, you know, detective brain, I looked into her profile friends. And there's someone called Eddie on there. He's got two profiles. I don't know if he's got anything to do with it. I'm not saying he has. So don't jump on that, guys. But anything I say could be relevant. It might not be, but I need to say it. I took a look at his profile and I didn't get some that great feelings from it. You know, he may have something to do with this. He may not. But it's just interesting. It's come through with the name that is on her profile. Then it said, "But her old man knows too much." So he does know. Donald does know stuff. He knows a lot. I don't think he knows everything, though. And then it said, that boy who helped her sleep. And I thought it said sleep. It wasn't clear, that part where it says sleep. I was sure it said sleep, but I wasn't too sure. And are they talking about Hunter? You know, that boy? Or are they talking about one of her brothers? And then they say they hit her. Force. So someone has hit Summer, you know, it did say hit her head or on the head. Before in the other slide, it said hit her on the head or something. And it says they hit her force. So has somebody hit her in the head with something? And then it said off her head. And I knew that to mean that Candace was off her head. She was maybe under the influence, or maybe she was off her head, going off her head angry. You know, maybe she lost it. And then it said her charged with it. So it sounds like there's going to be a charge, okay? And then they say, "My God, they're not from there." I don't know if that was in one sentence or not, but it was interesting. And then they say the man will find her. So it's going to be a man who will find Summer, by the sounds of it. And yes, she was hurt. So was hurt. It said help boy, so I'm thinking, are they talking about the brothers? You know, help the brothers, because they're in an unsafe environment, you know. So that's what I think it might mean. And then the name Matthews and Matthew came up 5 times. As I said before, I did mention it earlier, that name came through, Matthews. I think it was more Matthews than Matthew, but, you know, who knows? There could be a strong connection there with that. With a surname or someone's name, could be a business name, who knows? But as I said, we've got to keep our eyes open, think outside the square, because they do give cryptic clues sometimes. With a plane, interesting, with a plane. Now that is so weird, because when I heard the words "with a plane," I didn't know what that meant. I thought, okay, so you're talking about a plane, maybe an airport, because that was there as well. But saying "with a plane" makes me think that they're going to find her or something with a drone or a plane. Especially now that I know that search team's coming in. And then they say they are talking to the girl. Not sure what that's about, but there might be someone involved who's a younger girl who is a witness or something. But it does say friends here too. So they are talking to the girl who might be friends with them. And there's a business right here. So I'll go back to that building site clue that came through. It's reminding me of this business. Is it related to his work site? Could Summer be, around a building site, around one of his workmates' building sites? I don't know, guys. It's really interesting. And then we've got Pretty Stream. So that's interesting too. Like the fact that Spirit is saying Pretty Stream, it sounds like it's in a really nice, pretty, beautiful area. And it might just be a little stream. It might not be this massive creek or waterway. It might be just a little stream. And yes, they came up with the plan, and Bailey, where's Brad? So that might not even be relevant at all to this. It could be someone talking behind the scenes that we don't even know about that might be connected. But yeah, it's just so interesting these clues have come up. So basically, you know, what I've got from this so far, and even with a tarot reading, if you haven't seen it, you might want to go check it out. But it's a long reading too. It's a 2-hour reading. But basically, you know, I'd seen that Summer was a bit antagonistic. She was very energetic that day. I feel like her mother or grandmother has lost it. And it made more sense to me also when Hunter was being interviewed by the, by Chris, his name is, the homicide detective. He's retired now, but when he was interviewing Hunter, and Hunter said something in reference to his own grandmother and saying how they can get really cranky, and he was referring to Summer's grandmother becoming really cranky, and almost like she's lost it or she was losing it or something. I can't remember the exact phrase now, but it was along those lines. And I remember thinking, okay, someone has... sorry, my phone's going off here. Someone has, it sounds like, lost it and hit her. Okay, that's what it sounds like. Someone has lost it with Summer and hit her. So I don't know whether it was a force to the head with something like a weapon, or if it was just a slap in the head, you know, a backhand or something. I don't know exactly, but it does look like that. I don't believe it was intentional. I think this was an accident. I really do. Now, I know there's lots of speculation going around that there was a phone call between Candace and a drug dealer, or text messages or something going back and forth that Hunter had apparently seen on her phone. But I'm not sure about that either. I'm not really too sure just yet how true that is. But, you know, some people are saying, well, did she give away Summer to pay a drug debt? You know, and some people are saying, you know, it's very rare for traffickers to pick up 5-year-olds, especially. And it's extremely rare around that area, and especially because it's so rural and they live in such a really thick terrain. Like, you know, the landscape there is really thick. It's really full on to get through. So to actually get to their property and not alert all those dogs that were on the property, and to be able to take Summer through that, you know, terrain, all through the woods there, and then get out onto an open road, it was just, you know, this is what the Chris guy was saying. It's just like almost impossible. Like that is so, like, ridiculous almost. Like it's impossible to think of. It's not to say that it could never happen, but it would just be very highly, highly unlikely. And if she was taken, it would have to be someone she knew. So that's something else coming up. But my, you know, my thoughts on this is that Candace is the key to all of this. I feel like she is the one who knows. And she's the one who also, I feel, from the tarot, has called a female or talked to a female. It could be her mother. Could even be Allyson, who knows, about something that's happened that day. Okay, so it looks like it could be a girlfriend of hers, you know, or a family member that she's called to discuss this about. And I don't feel like she's given Donald the whole story. I don't know. I'm not saying that he's innocent at all, because I don't believe he's innocent. I know he knows stuff, but how much he knows, I don't know. I do know that he feels, like I feel that he knows that Summer is gone, that she's deceased. He might even know where her body is. but I don't believe he knows all of the details. I feel like she's left parts of the story out because he might be a ticking time bomb, and she can get scared of him when he gets angry. And that's proven through the criminal record that he's had from the domestic violence charges or whatever was going on there. I don't know if he was actually charged with it, but yeah, it was all that stuff going on with that. So there could be a lot of fear in her if she really, told him the full truth. But there is another element too, that she has a lover on the side, and that's come through, and I don't believe it's Hunter. I feel like it's, he's a minor. I feel like he needs to be really looked after in this as well. I'm not saying he's completely innocent, but he is a kid, guys. He is a kid, and she's the adult, and so was the grandmother that day. If anything, he's probably at the wrong place at the wrong time and got caught up in something. She did provide him with alcohol as well, and she's totally responsible. It's really sad if he knows something and he's not coming forward with the full truth. It's really sad, but I do believe the truth will come out. I'm a strong believer in that the truth does come out, and it will come out. And I feel Summer will be found. It may not be as soon as we want it to be, but I do feel she's near water as well. So I definitely feel that she's buried and that she's near water. And being religious, they would have placed a cross near her. There's something there. I don't think they just put her in like a shallow grave somewhere, or callously, I should say, put her in a shallow grave and just left her, to just any kind of element or whatever. I feel like they would have really taken time I'm saying that I'm not sure about Summer, her mother, because I feel like she is a bit removed. And if she did get someone else to deal with it, which I think she might have by the sounds of it, if the drug dealer texted "it's done," which I've heard happened, I don't know if that's true, but once again, that's what was told. If that's true that the drug dealer said to her "it's done," that might have been done at the time Summer was alive. I can't remember all the details now, my God. And maybe once again the timeline's wrong with Hunter. Maybe he did see that, but it wasn't at the store when Summer was alive. Maybe he saw it afterwards when, we just don't really know all the facts. There's still a lot of holes in the story, and a lot of discrepancies. But the detective does feel like Hunter was being really honest with him, as much as he could be. So for a child who was also drinking that day and who has ADHD, and he's under a lot of pressure too, don't forget. So he's only a teenager. So yeah, guys, I really do believe that Summer is not as far as they're trying to make out she is. I don't believe she's far, far away from the town. I think that she's pretty close. I don't know if she's right near their property, but that triangle on the map would be good to look at further, just to kind of see if there's any wooded areas, maybe like a stream or a creek. I don't know. I haven't really zoomed in too far into it just yet, but I want to have a look, and I want to know what you guys think. What do you think? What's your gut feelings on this? Or have you even looked into the case? Have you watched interviews or social media? In a minute you're going to see her TikTok videos of Summer and how she was, and it kind of gives you a bit of an idea of, the environment Summer grew up in and how her mother is. There was another video going around, and I haven't got it on this one, where she's just looking really out of it in a chair and playing some weird music and smoking, and she looks so out of it and high as what, I don't know. And she, my God, you look at that and you think, far out, you've got a child, you've got children, to look after, and who are you type thing? Who are you? You should have your children taken from you. Apparently the boys have been taken, but it's not been verified just yet. I really hope they do take the young children, because they're in an unsafe environment as well. So I really want to know what you guys think about this. I didn't want this to be a really long video tonight because I'm pretty tired myself. But, you know, this is where I feel drawn to, and I get a lot of passion. Like, I get passionate about this, these cases, and I really hope that Summer's found soon. I really pray that she's found soon. You know, hopefully these clues will make more sense too as we go along, you know, as things start to unravel and, you know, we discover more about the case. Hopefully, these clues might mean something as well, make more sense, I guess. But they have all their devices, I'm pretty sure. They've taken all of their phones and computers and stuff. So they would be analysing all that stuff and going into it. So, you know, I don't think she was that smart enough to delete everything. So it would be very interesting to see what happens. And as I said, you know, I would be absolutely so surprised if they came back innocent, guys. I mean, if that was the case, oh my God, like, I don't know. I'd be so shocked. But if that's the case, I'd also feel really guilty too. Because you don't want to really be pointing the finger at someone when you don't have that 100% proof. And, you know, by law, they are presumed innocent until found guilty. I don't know. I just have to go with my instincts on this. Maybe there's always truths in the lies too. Like, I do believe there are truths in lies. So, you know, maybe someone did come and take her away for her. Maybe when she was deceased, Candace got someone to take Summer to dispose of her body. We don't know, do we? I mean, she couldn't have done it because she had the boys with her. I don't know. Maybe the boys were with Donald. I'm not sure about. That's another thing we're trying to figure out. Where were the boys on the day that Summer was at the swimming hole? You know, why weren't her brothers with her? Why was Hunter, a 15-year-old, wanting to hang out with Summer, a 5-year-old, and the grandmother and Candace, you know? And obviously, some people are saying, well, you know, he got to do what he wanted with her because he could drink, you know, she gave him smokes as well. He was vaping that day, apparently. So, she was providing that stuff to him. So, you know, any kid that age would probably be thinking, oh, well, I can just go and have a few drinks with these people, you know. That makes more sense to me. And especially that she was friends with his mother. He probably trusted her. And who knows if there has been her crossing over that line with him. It's just strange by those, you know, that post he put up and the stuff that she was saying on there. I hope to God she hasn't done anything with him, but she's done enough already, you know. So I'm going to end this video with the TikTok videos that Candace has. She's got her own account on TikTok, and she's taken some photos and videos of Summer and her boys at various times, and in some of them we can see that Summer is happy. She's swinging along on a swing. She's happy in the water, you know, splashing around in at the water hole. I think that's the day that Candace had actually taken that recording, was on the day that she went missing. I'm pretty sure it is that one. But yeah, it would be, because Hunter's in that one as well. Anyway, I found the last video pretty haunting. I mean, I don't know about you, but the music that Candace has chosen to put on her daughter's last video that she says, I love you, mummy and daddy love you, or something. Oh my God, it's so eerie. I don't know if it's just me. Let me know if it's just me. I mean, it's a very sad tune, but it just sounds creepy. I don't know, guys. It just reminded me of like a haunted, like a horror movie or something. It just has a really weird sound, like the music. Have a listen and see what you think, and I'll be very interested to read your comments and, you know, converse with you in the chat as we go along with all of this. So thank you for joining me today again, and yeah, let me know, guys, and I'll catch up with you next time. Love and blessings. Only. Just like that, you're 6 years old and you take a nap, and you wake up and you're 25, then your high school sweetheart becomes your wife. Dogs out! When the party was nice, the party was bumping. Yippee-i-oh! And everybody having a ball. Yippee-i-oh!
very cute puppy, yuppy. I'm just a very cute puppy, yuppy. I'm just a very cute puppy, yuppy. I'm just a very cute puppy, woo. I'm just a very cute puppy, woo. I'm just a very cute puppy.
Don't play. been trying to slow it down. I've been trying to take it in. Ain't improving. I'm hitching up to your trailer. Get this thing moving.
It's red now.